So?
We're here.
Yes, we are.
The character we currently have on screen is not what we're going to be playing as. That's the trick.
Huh. What is the trick, then?
We're playing as someone else that has the same element, actually. Funnily enough.
Ah, yeah, Twilight Midna.
Yeah. Probably one of the more overpowered characters in the game, honestly.
Oh, yeah! She got most of her attacks are really interesting.
Yeah, so, for example, her third combo here...
It's a massive cannon!
And it is one of those attacks in the game that has a massive, a ginormous reach.
Yeah.
It's up there with the, Ganondorf's Twilight spear and the light arrows.
And her quirk is that.
Yeah, she has this. Yes, you notice that she has her bar under her special attack bar.
The thing is that as it fills up, it determines how quickly you were able to cover the screen in.
Yeah,
that weird move she did with Wolf Link, basically.
Right, that's what it's based on. I always wonder about it. I thought it was just Twilight magic, but yeah, that's what it is.
Okay, well,
yeah,
it's
like, so her special. Yeah, so it's her strong attack. Depending on how much you have filled up, it goes faster. If you start from the beginning, as I think I will show off here. Oh, maybe I will definitely show off. Yeah, I show off here. So notice here it goes really slowly, but it will still. Yeah, as you see here, depending on what enemies, and if enemies are caught in it, they will sort of freeze.
It'll be stunned for the entire duration, actually.
Yeah, so it's actually a good move, even then. But obviously, some enemies still have super armor. Like I'm pretty sure the. Jerkish Gibdos probably won't really care if I would use it or not. And obviously, someone like Ganondorf's super armor, Ganondorf obviously wouldn't care. But,
But most of her attacks, like, the fourth one has, if I remember correctly, Armor Breaker on it, actually.
Her fourth attack is her...
And we haven't shown it off yet, actually, so...
No, but it is when she starts playing around with
this one.
This one, yes.
Yeah, the first one is an Armor Break, and then it would juggle the enemy, so...
Yeah,
it's good for the heavy armor, the one who have.
Yeah, of course it doesn't really matter on super armored enemies like they give those, but.
Well, yeah, but it's good.
Give the sword jerks, as we stated before.
Like she is so goddamn powerful. I mean.
Yeah, and like as we saw there before, the Twilight Cannon, it has not only does it have big strong reach, it fires off three blasts, so a lot of enemies will be caught in it, and. Yeah, it also has just this ridiculous big range. Not only... Yeah, long range and just big range. As you notice there, we took out 50 enemies at the same time. I mean, like, I will admit that I'm probably overpowered, honestly. Like, that's kind of a problem. All the DLC characters you get start at level 1, so I just kind of have to guess if the characters are going to be strong or not. No, but when I'm starting to do... Before I start recording it, like, I'm just trying to get, okay, so what level would be good for all these levels that I want to show off? And sometimes I hit miss, and sometimes I just hit overkill.
She's still pretty powerful. She's still pretty powerful, because, I mean, I remember myself, yesterday I actually did, I was playing Legends, and I did one of the missions involving her. And even though I actually had to redo it twice... Actually, three times when I remember correctly, because I lost two times. One when I was because it was one where I had to fight both two different armies, the other army and the enemy army.
Mm-hmm. Oh,
and
okay, yeah.
It's an army where your commander is Sia, and you have to defeat both sides while at the same time protecting her.
Oh yeah.
And it's a massive juggle of making sure that you slowly capture keep so they stop spawning enemies, and at the same time dealing with the enemies gunning for her ass.
Yeah, it's Yeah,
Like I think I was under level, and I only had a 3-star mirror of shadow, like the level 1-1. But I still managed to pull my own and still A ranked it.
Yeah, like made two mistakes. Twilight Midna is still very, very strong.
Yeah, see, like, we're just waiting to be able to do this. See, boom! Yeah,
like she's one of the characters that are. If you don't, if you would for some reason not want to use the bow, And she's actually one of the characters that are pretty good to use in these all attacks are devastating missions, because you can just stand from a long, stand from far away, just use her third attack, and, you know, fire away.
Actually, I've come up with a bit of a good trick, actually, that works, I would say, almost a bit more efficient.
Than a bow?
It's, yeah, you pick Link, you pick Master Sword, and you do the first combo string, basically, for normal attack, then heavy, because those beams have super wide range, has a very long range, and because it's three, it can hit many enemies in a wide area.
Yeah, so like there are ways to, if you wouldn't want to use the bow, obviously, but it's just that the bow is usually the more safest trick, and it's also viable for all characters. Of course, I mean, it doesn't...
Although usually...
It's not as useful in the 3DS version, I think we mentioned this before again, but it's because of how they load in enemies, sometimes it just doesn't really work properly for the captains, and they just disappear. And so that is a problem on the 3DS version, but it still
That has
works.
Mostly to do with that's mostly to do with that the camera will only spot enemies. Or the camera is that if it's facing away an enemy, it will remove that enemy from you.
Yeah.
Despawn basically, so they can spawn other enemies in front of you.
Yeah.
And the thing is that if you don't, if the captains are out your camera around, they will despawn. They will still be there, but they will just don't be theirs to target on.
Yeah, and if you turn around the camera too fast and you still have a lot of enemies on the screen, then the captains still won't be there, which is, you know, a problem.
I mean, that can happen when you take over keeps and the map says it's behind you, but you can't target until you actually swing the camera around. Mm.
It happens sometimes in this game as well, but they have...
Not as often,
because I believe how they load in enemies in this game also work a bit differently. I think not only is it... It's mostly centered on the screen, obviously, but I think it also works in a bit of an area around you as well. You
know, yeah, so you, I think it's something
just
like
to be
that.
Like safe, so that you attack more enemies when you do area of attack, you know, area damage.
AOE. That went fast.
Yeah, like, it went about as fast as it would do if I had used a bow, so, you know.
Yeah.
So yeah, again, Twilight Mina is a good character for these missions.
Well, she is the better character.
The better Midna?
Yes.
Yeah, I would agree with that, honestly. Like, I'd like normal Midna, but I would definitely say that Twilight Mina is a lot, like, leagues better than her.
Well, yeah, but also for obvious of other reasons, too.
Right. No, like... It's kind of funny. One of the ending dialogues that she has, she will sometimes say, like, oh yeah, you know what? This form rocks. Why would I ever want to use the imp form ever again? So, you know.
Well, in the game, she can sacrifice this form for her imp form. God damn it.
It's funny, like, there's a mission centered around Twilight Mint. Well, sort of centered around Twilight Midna in the Legends, in the 3DS Legends mode. It's one of the Linkle missions where, so for some reason, they found a crystal that turns Midna back into her normal form instead of imp form.
I think it's basically the same crystal that infected Link to become permanently Wolf Link.
Yeah, probably.
I think it's something like that. At least that's what I'm assuming. I don't think they ever showed the crystal itself. So.
No, I don't think they do. But it's probably that same crystal.
But yeah, that mission is awesome because it has two out of three of my favorite female characters. So
yeah, Linkle and the Twilight Midna, which is
yeah. The only thing missing is Lana.
Isn't she in that mission? No, she isn't actually.
No, because you know Linkle takes place usually after, at some point later.
Yeah, but if I remember correctly, they just come back to the Palace of Twilight. And he's like, yeah.
No, they don't.
No.
I think maybe it's Impa that shows up again?
No, like, I remember, like, it was in Palace of, like, that mission takes place in Palace of Twilight. I just don't remember if it was because they had to come back because he, like, oh yeah, there's something evil here and we need to check it out.
Yeah, I think it was, no, it was Sheik that, that came back. Whatever.
The point is that they're at the end of the mission, then Twilight Mina is like, okay, well, I have to give it up, otherwise I won't be able to stop the Dark Forces in here. And then she does, and then she's back to Imp Midna. So, lamers, I guess.
Yeah.
And then you still have to unlock Twilight Mina in Adventure Mode, because... LOL. It's kind of weird, actually. There's a lot of visions like that in the 3DS story mode, where you have characters that you can play as, but you don't actually unlock until you have unlocked them in adventure mode.
Yeah, Twilight Princess is one of them.
Yeah.
I was like, oh great, I get to play as her, like, unlock her, but nope, it's like, what? I need to, and, well, and since you can't unlock her until you actually beat the normal story first, because it's part of the red area.
Oh, really?
I think so. No, maybe I was wrong.
No, I think you're right about that, actually. I think it's part of the gray area.
Maybe someone in the comments will correct me.
Yeah, but I mean, again, like, it's, you're supposed to do story mode before you start adventure mode, but that's boring. Oh, well. So, yeah. Twilight Min, like, a big part, big good thing, well, one of the better things about Twilight Min is the fact that she's both wild. That, unlike most characters have, like, have a special in either doing a lot of damage in a group or doing damage on single target enemies. I feel like Twilight Min is one of the few that can do great against both. Because she has her first combo attack where she knocks people up to the ground, which I don't show off properly because I'm an idiot.
Oh, you can actually, and the thing is that you can juggle with that thing.
Yeah, like you knock them up into the air, you can keep on doing that, or you can, you know, keep on going until her fourth combo where she starts whacking around with the bridge.
Yeah, although I actually did discover that, the whole, like, the juggle combo.
Oh, and as I saw there, actually, Ruto also dropped the material for us there. What happens is, we mentioned that before, and what happens is, it's not because you hit the character with the same, with the attack as you killed the boss with. It's because they're on the camera, so. Oh, well. Yeah, still, it wasn't without a bit of fun, I guess.
Everything is fun with her.
Yeah, because she has a good moveset. Ridiculously good moveset, honestly. Again, Twilight Minna. I think it's actually the first time I got an A rank on one of those defeat all the and sorry.
They should
quiz,
be
on the quiz mission.
I'm not usually that hard.
So look at all these spears I have. Useless.
Yeah. You know, yeah, like, no, the game forces you to actually play it because you need the, you know,
no, like, honestly, all those spears are bad spears. They don't even, like, you know, they could be good if you, you know, if you took them to another level or they have good abilities. No, those were all just straight up bad. It's actually, and I think that's kind of fun that we could actually technically do Lana's level 3 spear mission right now.
Yeah, have fun with that.
Yeah, but like, we haven't even gotten her level 2 spear yet. So yeah, that's kind of weird how the game works sometimes. Also, hey, a water bomb. It's fun because we're playing as a Twilight Princess character and using the water bomb. Which is a Twilight Princess exclusive.
Yeah.
Unless you're, I don't know.
No, so far I think that is this only game that's had water bombs.
No, I mean, I remember there was something in Ocarina of Time where you could shoot the bomb and it would, you know, underwater, which was, it was some weird glitch thing in...
Well, it's Ocarina of Time, like, there's glitches everywhere in that game. it's a good game and everything, but like many N64 games, apparently they seem to be riddled with glitches.
Yeah, right.
I mean, just look at people doing, you know, tool assist runs and even Awesome Game Gun Quick and stuff like that, so...
Yeah, how fast could you complete Mario 64 again without any stars?
What is it, like 12 minutes?
I think.
That's like unassisted?
Yeah, I think. That's just luck based, depending on if the glitch works for you or not.
Something like that, but like seriously, that game is, or that entire, like.
Yeah,
for being a pretty strong console for what it was, at least with its first party lineup and stuff like that, the glitches are unbelievable. I mean,
I feel like that's the best part about old games. I mean, yeah, fine. There are glitches in new games as well, but there's a lot more fun glitches in old games. Older games, I believe.
Yeah, I agree.
I'm probably wrong about that, and someone would probably correct me. But I mean,
glitches are everywhere. But it's just that it feels different when if you see it from an old game compared to like a new game.
Oh, hey, here we go. So remember in that mission a long time ago where I said it was like some sort of gimmick where if you did, if you let a specific captain die, a ghost would appear?
Yeah, well, we just busted that ghost, so...
Yeah, great, grand. Yeah, but so what happens is they, you know, they put a curse on your army and they will have...
It has nothing to do with the moon.
Yeah, the you know, it demoralizes the entire army until you defeat the ghost. And, but, you know, the ghost spawns directly in front of you because it's a ghost.
Yeah, and busted makes me feel good, so...
I believe also that the captain, actually, the original captain spawns in at half health. And again, they spawn in enemy territory just to mess with you. So,
they are supposed to die anyway, so...
I guess they have to, because he literally died as soon as he spawned, it felt. Stupid. Oh yeah, we should probably mention this, by the way. This is a mission to unlock Agita.
Oh god, why are we doing this?
And she's on our team, so we can't even beat her up to get her to join our team.
Oh my god.
Unlike all the other missions. All the other missions where you unlock characters.
I was about to say, I was about to say, either they switched out the legends, because I remember having to defeat them to unlock them. So, apparently, the team over at...
Omega Force, great technical.
Omega Force decided to, you know, let's not punish this slowly that character, because, you know, she's way too innocent for this game.
No, actually, I believe it's because she's the only character that doesn't lead an army at any point. Again, I'm probably wrong about this. She probably has... some in the Twilight Field, actually.
She did lead a small group, but that's still a excuse for not being...
It's because... Yeah, again, she's a joke character. She couldn't lead an army if she tried.
Yet she's still in this game!
Yeah, it's weird.
That's still the biggest... I remember when I was looking for this game, and she got announced. I was just, what... Yeah. It was still like I'm asking, what the fuck? She just broke reality!
With the tear of Twilight. Man, Twilight magic is bullshit. Honestly.
Not as bullshit as, you know, friendship.
Yeah. Also, should probably mention that Twilight Midna just saved Midna.
There's a paradox there somewhere.
Yeah, how does this work exactly? So, actually, I have a question.
Twilight magic!
No, like, okay, so when we got Fire and Chaos back there, Midna actually gave Twilight Midna a compliment for killing so many enemies. Is that being egotistical?
Yeah.
It must be, right? Because you're complimenting your own future...
Yeah, I mean, of course, it's like if I pretended to be, you know, a superhero, and then I go around claiming that the superhero is awesome, and no one knows I'm the superhero except me.
I'm sure there's a origin story somewhere there in some comic that has that exact story.
Probably.
Yeah, and also Midna gives Twilight Midna a compliment, and Twilight Midna decides to say, "Yeah, you know what? Imform sucks. I love this." while Imform Midna is in here.
Well, of course, Imform Midna sucks because, you know, she's. Her magic is holding back. You see how much Ash is kicking compared to Imp?
Impna? No, let's not make that a word.
No, but like, compared to her Imp formula, I mean, of course she is the ruler of Twilight.
Yeah.
Although I still think it's weird that a bridge is an attack for her.
Yeah, like, especially that tree bridge. When did she ever summon a tree bridge? Like, I remember her summoning a stone bridge. I don't remember a tree bridge at any point.
Actually, there was when you need to get to Kakariko Village. The bridge was taken out, and then you had to go back to the forest.
Was that a tree bridge?
Yeah, it was made of a tree.
Oh, well, never mind then. I'm wrong.
It would still be cool if that giant tree later on... that giant stone bridge would actually gonna be one of her magic forms endings, actually.
Yeah, that would have been cool.
I don't remember what her magic drain is.
Because
the one we saw was you hitting A, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so I just don't know.
Yeah, we'll see it later when we start beating up
Also because usually most of the DLC characters I haven't gone magic form, so I don't actually know how they're looked.
Yeah, you'll soon see, actually.
You know, it's like you said a couple of videos ago about most DLC characters, you don't get to see their chest opening animation.
Yeah. Oh, actually, I should probably mention, by the way, that in the Japanese, Twilight Midna is actually called True Midna.
Well, this is a true form.
Yeah, like, I don't... I agree, actually. Also, her weapons, I should probably mention the names of them. The third level one is the Mirror of Shadow. The second one is Mirror of Silence, and level 3 is Mirror of Twilight.
Well, that one looks exactly the one from the game.
Yeah, so that's neat.
Like seriously, like, I remember when I played Twilight Princess, and you actually saw her true form, and you know when she said, like, you know, something about, you know, being silenced by her beauty or something like that, I was like, yeah, I am!
I mean, it's kind of the joke, isn't it? That she's, oh no, I was just this imp all the time. No, it turns out I actually have a body.
Her imp is not ugly. I would say it's more like cute if you want to stretch it that far instead.
Yes.
But this form, yeah.
Yeah, I mean it's the ultimate joke. Whatever. She probably actually saw that before. We did actually take out a lot of enemies with the Twilight Midna in magic form. And I was, you know, without picking up any magic refills. So I would say if you're going for that achievement, then I would say that go for Twilight Midna.
Go for broke.
Go for Twilight Midna.
Take Twilight Midna, go for broke.
Yeah. Just get all the upgrades first in the badge market.
Well, at least try to get the cannon.
Yeah, the cannon is great. Oh my god, a wolf!
Actually, speaking of Twilight, you know how there is a bunch of mangas based around the games?
Yeah, there's one based on the Twilight Princess, isn't there?
It's actually coming out. It's been released now, so...
Oh, well then.
People are already...
Translating it.
Mm-hmm. So I know what book I'm gonna get. Oh, I got all the other ones, so...
I'm still waiting for the retranslation of Part 5 from JoJo's.
So it's really hard getting those.
Yay, we unlocked the Geeta!
No!